up, YouTube? Breaking people with shock rating takeover is one of my favorite things to do, and I get the question on how to do that a lot, so I am here to answer it for you guys today. Now, it's going to be a pretty quick video. It's pretty simple. Go to your animations. What you want is Spin Jumper 4. That's my favorite. I feel like it gives you the best spin animations, and out of all the ones I've tried on all kinds of players, this one actually breaks people the most consistently. It's not the most fastest spin, but when he does that little slow spin to the turn, and there's good fast spins in the animation, but when he does the slow one, it usually breaks people pretty much every time if they're close to you. And then Hop Jumper is the other one. I use normal 15. Not a lot of people use it. This just gives you a quick hop back, and if they're pressing up on you and you just hit them with a quick normal 15 Hop Jumper, it breaks them, especially if you're in shock rating takeover. Even if you're not, if you have space rated, it'll break them. James Harden and Steph Curry, normal 21. These are all other, you know, they're good hop jumpers that I use as well. But if you're actually trying to break ankles, the most consistent normal 15 is the one you want. None of the other animations matter, so if you guys want, you know, jot that down, yada yada. But it's kind of crazy, you know, in NBA 2K20, ankle breakers aren't really the main thing this year. You can only really break people with snatchbacks, and there's a couple other moves, but there's not a whole lot of, you know, just like really nice ankle breakers, like, you know, momentum step back like there was last year, momentum spin. But I feel like shock rating takeover, doing the setbacks, doing the spin shots, those give really nice ankle breakers while looking pretty neat. Now, you can't drop people to the ground with the shock rating takeover, unfortunately. If you could, that would be a whole, oh man, that would be nice. But you have to have playmaking takeover to actually break somebody to the ground. Now, you can, when you're in shock rating takeover, you still can snatch back, and they'll, like, you know, they'll touch the floor, they'll bend their knees, but you actually have to, you know, have playmaking takeover to make them fall over their face. So let's get into it. So all I'm doing, this is just the hop 15. All you do is pull the joystick down away from the hoop. So I'm going left, I pull it down left. I'm going right, I pull it down right. That'll give you that little quick step back every single time. Super easy to do, nothing to it. Like I said, if you're going to the corner, just pull it down away. So basically pull the joystick toward the corner. If it's too complicated, basically just pull it away from the basket every single time. And you see right here, you can be standing still and you can pull it away and you'll get that little jump back animation, even if you're not running. That really, really gets people because they don't expect you to just, you know, not dribble and just step back like that. They expect you to always be going forward when you're dribbling. So anytime you go backwards while you're dribbling, you saw in some of the clips, it just messes people up. And then you see here, you know, you can do it in the mid-range, you can do it in a three-point. No matter where you are on the court, you're going to be able to get the step-back animation. If they're pressed up on you, like they're riding your hip, do that, and it'll break them every single time when you're in shock rating takeover. Now, when it comes, and of course, you know, you just let go of it before you actually take the jumper. If you stay holding it down, you'll actually get the jump shot out of it. And, you don't want that unless, you know, you're ready to shoot. You can press X as well instead of pulling it down, but I recommend pulling it down. And when it comes to the spin jumper, all you're going to do is double tap X when you're running. It's going to make you go left, make you go right. Whatever way you're pointing your joystick is the way you're going to go. Say you're running to the left and you point it to the right. After you double tap X, you're going to go right, you're going to go left. Honestly, I mean, it doesn't really matter the direction. Of course, if there's two people to the right, you're going to want to go left. If you, you know, I try to split people if they're kind of playing sides, and I'll just spin in between both of them and get a nice, you know, free throw line midi. That's my sweet spot for it. If you have hot spots, it's going to help a ton. If you want to get the super spin like I did right there, all you do is do a 360 with your right joystick away from the hoop. If you do it toward the hoop, you're going to get the super spin dunk animation that you guys see statistics do a lot. And you can also just spin it kind of 720 and get the regular spin. But if you just want to do a normal spin jumper, I recommend just double tapping X. It's the quickest way. And it's easy to time off that, because if you do a spin shot, you're pretty much going to want to finish every time. It's not like the hop jumper where you're going to, you know, where you're going to use it as ankle breakers and then do another move after. With this one, you're usually going to shoot every time because you're going to pick up your dribble if you don't. But, I mean, that's pretty much it, man. Let me know what you guys think. Let me know what hop jumper, what spin jumper you guys use. If you have any other questions, shock rating takeover, man. Thing's amazing. You can break angles with it. Oh, also, if you don't have shock rating takeover on or activated, you can use space creator. It does the same thing too. It helps with step back, spin jumper, all that stuff. Now, it is nowhere near as efficient as shock rating takeover. I feel like shock rating takeover, you'll get it every time. Space creator gets you like 50% of the time. But let me know what you guys think, man. This is Tony. Catch you guys next one. I'm out. Peace.